Hello everyone, my name is Mike, and in this video I'll show you how you can use NodeMailer in Node.js to send email messages from your Gmail account for free. So yeah, let's see how we can do that. So what is NodeMailer, you ask? Well, NodeMailer is a module for Node.js applications which make it easy to send emails from your Gmail account or from any other provider. Just in this video we will be showing directly from a Gmail account. But again, you can use any account of your choice. So let's see how it works. So let's go on W3 Schools example. And as you will see here, we are using NodeMailer. And then we are passing some options. So we are passing our service, which is Gmail. And then the details of our Gmail account. So the user, which is our email, and then our password. But I'll show you in a bit, we can make it so we don't use our password, but a new password we will create just for this application. Now next, on our email options, we can pass from where it will be sent, and here we usually pass our own email, and then the email we will be using, and then where we're going to send it. So here we pass the recipient email. Now on the subject, we pass the subject, and the text is what it will be shown in the email. And that's mostly it. Then we use the send mail function, and then we pass the mail options there. So first of all, we have to set up your Gmail account so it allows Node.js to send emails automatically without requiring authentication every time. And what I mean by that is, in case you have two-factor authentication or something like that, or also Gmail, if it detects that emails being sent from a bot or a Node.js application in our case, it will not send the message and it will block the app. So step number one is to click the link down the description, and you should be redirected to log into your Gmail account. So go ahead and do that. After you log in, you shall be redirected to this page. Now it looks like that. But you may have an option here to turn off and on. And I'll explain right now what that is. So in my case, it says that I have two-factor authentication turned on. So it is enabled. And it says that in order to use my Gmail account for an application, I'll have to create a specific password for that application for less secure apps access. So in case that shows up, then skip to step number two. But if it doesn't, just click here enabled. So just turn it on and you should be okay. Now for step number two, in your case, if you have two-factor authentication enabled, and you should, it's a must, then click on top right here and click manage your Google account. Then go to security, scroll down until you find app passwords, click, and here what we have to do is select an app, and we will do other. So we will use a custom name, and let's do Node.js and click generate. Now you will be generating an app password. So copy this right here, your app password, and save it somewhere. We will be using it in a bit. Now that our Gmail is set up and ready to go, let's close these windows and let's create a Node.js app. To do that, just create a folder, name it however you like. I'll name it NodeMailer Tutorial, which by the way, I'll have the code down in the description, the finalized code. So if you want to download it, just click the GitHub link down in the description and you will be redirected there. So open your folder, click up here and type cmd to open the command line in your project folder. Now here what we have to do is run npm init. And that requires you to have Node.js downloaded already. So let's click enter. I'll leave all my fields empty, and to do that I'll just spam enter. Now what we have to do is open our project in our code editor. I use Visual Studio Code, and to open my project in my code editor, I just run code, and then space, and then dot, and it opens the whole project folder in my Visual Studio Code. But in case you use another editor, that's fine, just open the project there and follow along. So now we will create a new file called index.js. And here we will copy paste the code we got from W3 Schools. So let's go back, copy it, and paste it here. Now, first thing we need to do is to download NodeMailer package. So let's copy it, open terminal, new terminal, and run npmi NodeMailer.save. And it should download fairly quick. Now let's close the terminal. And now let's replace the values here. So let's first go to mail options and put our email here. And here you put the email you'll be using to send the email from. So let's do my email. And the reception can be any email. It can be a Yahoo email, it can be a Gmail email, it doesn't really matter. So let's put another email, and then for subject I'll just leave it as it is, same for the text, and that's it. Now let's go up here, and here is where we log in to our account. So for user I'll put the same email, and for password, now if you don't have the two-factor authentication turned on and you enabled less secure apps, here you can put your password you use to log into your Gmail account, but I do not recommend that. I recommend turning on the two-factor authentication and then creating the app password as I show you. But you can just put your password if you want. Let's copy our app password and put it here. And that's it. So let's test it. Let's open terminal, new terminal, and run node index.js, and there we go. So it basically logged in to our email, and then it sent the email. So let's go to our reception email, click Gmail, and there we go. So you should see it got an email from my Gmail, and it says sending email using node.js. That was easy. And there we go. So let's go back. Now another great option you have is to send an HTML email. And let me show you how you can do that. So instead of text, you can pass another option called HTML. And you can pass HTML code inside it, but it has to be inside a string. Okay, so let me give you an example. Let's say, let's open an H1 tag and then put the text inside there, and you can put a whole HTML code here. So now let's run our code same way, and then let's check, and it sends the email pretty quick. So as you will see, after 1 to 2 seconds I got the email, and it says sending email using Node.js, and it says that was easy. And as you see, because I used the same subject, it continued to the same email. So another thing I want to show you is that you can send the same email to many receptions. And to do that, instead of passing a string to the to property, you can pass an array of strings. So let's say this is one of the emails I want to send it. And another email can be, say we want to send it on ourselves as well. So let's put my email as the recipient and another email as well. Again, you can have as many as you want here. You can have 500 emails, doesn't really matter. It only limits on how many emails you can have normally in Gmail. So that's it for this video. Let me know down in the comments if you'd like to see an extended tutorial in NodeMailer where we go through how you can send an email using an HTML template, so you don't have to pass the code right here, but you can use an HTML template and then you can pass dynamic fields to it. So you can send a more dynamic email. I'd really appreciate if you hit that like button, subscribe, and hit that bell notification so you don't miss my next videos.